My name is Eugene Katsevich, and I'm an assistant professor of statistics and data science at Wharton, and I do research into statistical methodology and its applications to genomics. Genomes are the sequence of genetic letters that we all have in each cell of our body. So it's just a long string of A's, C's, T's, and G's. And genes are just simply segments of this long string. All humans have 3 billion genetic letters, and 99% of these are shared among humans. 1% of those genetic letters are different, and it's what makes me different from you. And these letters that are different across humans are called genetic variants. Genetic variants often have the function of controlling the activities of nearby genes. If at a given genetic variant, instead of having an A, you have a T, then this might actually lead to one or more nearby genes having a different level of activity than is normal. Genes having abnormal levels of activity will translate into potentially increased or decreased disease risk. One way of understanding the impact of a genetic variant is to just test out what happens when you introduce that genetic variant into a population of cells. And you can do this with the help of this tool called CRISPR. If you take this idea and scale it up to thousands of different genetic variants and tens of thousands of genes in potentially hundreds of thousands of cells, you get what's called a CRISPR screen. So the kinds of large data sets that come out of CRISPR screens are very noisy, and it's hard to disentangle the true biological relationships that are there from the noise. And computationally, these data sets tend to be fairly large. I realized that some of the statistical techniques I had been developing in my PhD actually could be applied to basically overcome some of these analysis challenges. And so applying those statistical techniques to this new application of CRISPR screens led to the birth of a new methodology called SCEPTRE. A biologist who has run a CRISPR screen and has these kinds of data, they would download SCEPTRE onto their computer, they would load their CRISPR screen data into R, and then they would analyze it using SCEPTRE, and then at the end, they would get a list of relationships between genetic variants and genes that are supported by their data. The statistical advantage of SCEPTRE is that it simultaneously sort of decreases the number of those false positives while increasing the number of true positive associations that you find. So since we released SCEPTRE in 2020, we have had increasing interest in the methodology and the software. And a recent success story has been a collaboration with a group of scientists from the New York Genome Center. We found that there were not very many false positives at all in their data, but on the other hand, we found a bunch of interesting biological associations that helped explain the way that various blood traits arise from our inherited genetic variants. And this study was one of the first of its kind in terms of using CRISPR screens to understand the genes involved in certain human traits and diseases. And so it actually ended up being quite influential, and it was published in Science earlier this summer. It was extremely gratifying for me to see this tool that I had built actually being applied to a real data set and used to discover new biological insights. We are going to be able to get insights into human diseases and how we might diagnose and treat them of a kind that we have never seen before. And so that's part of the reason why I'm so excited about being in this field.